Hey guys, it's Jesse with INameless. Well, today's the day. It is September 23rd. Is today the end of days? I don't think so. But let's go ahead, jump into this one, and get to the bottom of why today is so significant. Okay guys, so first and foremost, we're not ending today. The world is not coming to an end today by Nibiru or anything like that. I mean, weird things might be happening in the sky and that have been prophesized in the Bible, but we're not dying by Nibiru. Nibiru's not killing anybody. So, I want to get into this and just let you guys know that you got to remember there's a lot of deception out there. Some of these people out there and some of these channels, if you're looking at Nibiru, look into what they've done last year. Because some of these channels just replay the same stuff every year. They just change their record or their video's date. So some of these channels from 2016, 2015, 2014 have played videos similar or the exact same video stating that the world is coming to an end on Nibiru. It's been happening for a while on YouTube. They just replay the same stuff over and over again. It's ridiculous. So, please be weary of this and just know that today might be a significant day in the stars. Something's happening there. But other than that, nothing's happening. Do better research, do more research, so you know it's nothing like that. Now, another verse of it, Nibiru to the side, is people are saying that it's going to be the start of the 7 years. And first I want to say, in the Bible, anyway, with all that's being said, it's September 23rd, and it's always a date. The Bible never, ever sets a date. It clearly states that no man knows, not even angels, nobody knows when the end of days is going to happen. No one. It's just going to happen. It's going to catch everybody off guard. It just happens. So we're not going to know. It's just happening. So therefore, it's not going to be September 23rd. We all know about it, right? Who knows? But from the Bible, if you take the word from the Bible, we do not know the date. Nobody knows the date. Nobody's going to know the date. So that's just one thing. On the other hand, there's a lot of different versions that people kind of are just taking little bits. I do have the Bible right here and want to show you what the verse actually says so you're more informed, but that is more of a prophetic way to go about it. That's what's supposed to happen, but it doesn't ever claim and say that we are going to die today. It just states a lot of happening. But anyways, out of most of this, what I find most interesting is what it says in the Bible at the beginning of Revelations when it explains this. It does say what's happening in our sky, and I'm gonna play a short clip just to show you guys what is actually happening today, not with Nibiru blowing us up or destroying us, but what is actually happening with the stars and in the constellations. Because what is happening today only happens just once. It has never happened before, it'll never happen again. So that's pretty cool. So we'll show you this clip and then we'll go from there.
The great sign in heaven of Revelation chapter 12, verse 1. A great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. And she was with child, and she cried out, being in labor and in pain to give birth. Jesus calls such events fearful sights and great signs from heaven. The great sign from heaven will be the largest sign that has ever heralded a prophetic event. We are on the Temple Mount in Jerusalem. It is 3 a.m. on September 23, 2017. The first constellation in the great sign is rising above the horizon. This is Leo, the constellation of the Royal Lion. When the dawn breaks, we'll see that Leo is worn as a crown of royalty by the Virgin Princess. The lion forms the appropriate crown for her because she is of the house of David, the lion of the tribe of Judah. Significantly, this is the highest royal lineage of all the nations. This means the virgin is also born of the lineage of the high scepter of the seed of Adam. In her belly is the second Adam, the Savior of the world. On this fateful day, the virgin is clothed in the sun, and the moon is at her feet. Sunlight floods the sky, and since the virgin is clothed in the sun, we cannot see her, so we turn off her artwork. But the prophecy clearly states that the great sign is to appear in the heaven. High noon approaches. Then, on this special day, the sun turns as black as sackcloth, and the stars quickly fill the sky. Just like on the day of the crucifixion, it will remain dark for an incredible 3 hours. We stop the motion and zoom in. We fill the screen with our two constellations. To better see how the constellations are formed, we generate blue lines between their stars. Then we turn off the constellation artwork, leaving us with the lines of each constellation. We first turn our attention to the constellation of Leo. In Leo, the alpha or brightest star is Regulus, the regal king star. 8 additional bright stars are used to form the constellation. But this leaves us 3 stars short of the 12 stars prophesied to crown the Virgin. On this special day, 3 wandering stars are in rare formation within the boundaries of Leo. They are Venus, Mars, and Mercury. This gives us the prophesied 12 stars to form the crown. Now we move to Virgo. Her left hip is formed by the alpha star named Spica, which means the seed. Her right hip is formed by the zeta star named Hes, which means the branch. On this day, the Virgin is to give birth to the king planet between these two stars. Like all the planets, Jupiter, which images the Messiah, was misnamed and misdescribed by the Greeks. The king planet images the rescuing power of our Messiah. Because of this planet's gravitational strength, it takes countless hits or impacts for us from many of the dangerous objects that cross into the inner solar system. Also, the king planet has just spent 9 months in the belly of the Virgin, reinforcing the prophetic imagery of the scriptures. To illustrate this wonder, we will now run the clock backward for a year. Notice that the king planet stops and turns around twice in retrograde motion while in the belly of the Virgin. In turn, the moon flies by along the ecliptic every month. This action by the moon will give us a means to mark the passing of the months. We stop our backward motion. We now change into forward motion. We pause the motion as Jupiter enters the belly of the Virgin. Now count the times that the moon flies by while Jupiter is in the Virgin's belly. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And in just under 10 months, we arrive back at our fateful day, September 23rd, 2017. Now we will recap the prophetic imagery in the great sign. First, we have Virgo, the Virgin Princess, imaging the Virgin Mary. Second, the Virgin is clothed in the sun, imaging the life-giving Spirit of God. Third, the crescent moon is at her feet, heralding this day as the Jewish Feast of Trumpets. Fourth, on this day, the Virgin also has a special crown of 12 stars, representing the lineage of the high throne of the nation of Israel. Fifth, the Virgin gives birth to the crown prince, the Messiah. Sixth, the crown prince has just spent a long 9 months in her womb, the time of human gestation. Seventh, so we can see this wonder, a special heavenly event causes the sky to fall dark for 3 hours in the middle of the day. The combination of all 7 of these independent actions into a great sign brings to life the exact imagery of the prophecy. However, if this sign were to occur repeatedly in the course of the travels of the planets, then how could we interpret it as a significant event? How often does this configuration occur in the heavens? The answer, it occurs only this one time. At no other time is the Virgin clothed in the sun, with the moon at her feet, while she is wearing a crown of 12 stars at the same time she gives birth.
This is an actual page of my Bible, and I will be reading from, of course, this Bible. Okay, guys, so Revelation 12. And there appeared a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. And she, being with child, traveling in birth, and pain to be delivered. And I know, one second, guys, So I do know that at the beginning of the clip I showed you, they went over this, but I just wanted to read this part again as they did, just to show you that it was a part of the Bible, because it was just a video clip. You know, I try to show the truth on here, so I didn't point you. I don't believe any video that's in there, even clips. So I wanted you guys to know that what that guy said at the beginning of the clip is true. That part is in the Bible. So let me get back to this. Okay, painted to be delivered. Okay. And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon, having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns upon its heads. And his tail drew the third part of the stars of the heaven, and did cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman which was ready to be delivered, for to devour her child as soon as it was born. And she brought forth a man child who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron, and her child was caught up unto God and to his throne. And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she hath a place prepared of God, that thy should feed her there 1,260 days. And going on, and there was war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, and the dragon fought on his angels and prevailed. Not either was their place found any more in heaven, and the great dragon was cast out, the old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. Now I think that is the best line of Revelation 12, as it just clearly states it deceived the whole world. Alright guys, have a good day. Don't let it get you down. You know, go to work. Don't quit. Spend time with your family if you already took the day off. Do what you gotta do. I hope this clears everything up. And again, I just was trying to help out whoever was worried about today and try to give them a little bit better understanding of why today brought up so much controversy. God bless you guys, and please just enjoy your day. And I will see you tomorrow.